Good morning, Pride. I'm Macy.
And I'm Mike. And welcome back to MPTV.
Prom is April 20th at the Science Center from 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Tickets are on sale now on GoFan.com.
Guest pass forms can be found in the activities office. Students should not purchase a couple's ticket until their guest pass has been approved. Any student without an approved guest pass will be turned away at the door.
Students have until 4-7 to ask a friend or a partner to prom in a unique and appropriate way and tag at MTPSTUCO, MTPSTUCO on Instagram. Teachers will vote and the winning couple will be given two free prom tickets.
Now we have Evan with the cheapest places to get prom dresses.
Good morning, Pride. With prom getting closer, I know it's getting harder and harder to find a prom dress that you want and in the range that you want. Our first option is Goodwill. Now hear me out on this one. I understand that it's hard to find good dresses at Goodwill, but it's honestly not hard to find a diamond in the rough that's around $20 to $30. Next is Ross Dress for Less. There's many different kinds of dresses that you could find here that could fit your style and your budget. Our third option is Windsor Dress Shop. They have a range of prices that are actually affordable. Now they can have fairly expensive dresses, but that is super fancy and puffy dresses. And if that sounds good to you, perfect. Now personally, I prefer Mills Mall's location, but the Chandler one is pretty good too. Our fourth is Burlington, which could be rare to find a good dress, but it never hurts to try. Our last option is Amazon. Now be careful, because you want to get your dress on time so you can get it tailored or get it to how you want it to fit it. And that's all. Have a great day, Pride.
Operation Hydration has officially started by One Day at a Time Club.
You can donate money or cases of water to the front office. For more information on community service hours, see Mr. Reeder in room C-141.
Zombie Prom the Musical is this Friday and Saturday.
Here's Macy with behind the scene of the musical.
Mountain Point Theater Company is putting on Zombie Prom the Musical. This is Mountain Point's second time performing this show, and they're incorporating even more wow factor with the set, dances, and costumes to elevate this musical.
We do a lot, like it's a lot of hard work, but it's really fun once you like finally get all the dances and the singing down, because like we have such a good environment, and like now that we have lighting and sound, everything's just so much better.
The hard work that the talented cast and crew put into the show is because of their love for the theater program.
Zombie Prom has been a wonderful experience for me. It's been so fun getting to learn the dances and then the songs and kind of putting the two together. It's been crazy, but we've been pushing through. We have an amazing cast and crew getting us through and wonderful directors, so it's been a great experience so far.
We do a lot of really cool dancing. We have an amazing stage manager and amazing crew who helps this happen. And our band is really cool too.
This musical is the last show of the year, but they are ending the school year with a bang. This musical has genres of music for everyone to enjoy. The show has so many surprising and funny moments.
Grease meets a zombie. Don't think too many zombies. Plus high school drama.
My favorite dance of all time is It's Alive, because we get to do like a little thriller moment, which is super fun. So you guys should all come see it. Also, there's teachers in it.
You can enjoy this musical this Friday at 6 p.m. and Saturday at 1 p.m. and 6 p.m. $7 for students and $10 for adults. You can buy your ticket at the door or reserve them online. Tomorrow, juniors are taking the AZ Sci. The rest of the school has a digital learning day, so please don't come to school.
Please complete your assignments in Schoology by 1:30 for credit.
Wednesday the 10th, juniors are taking the ACTs, while the rest of the school has another digital learning day.
The ACTs are next week. I asked some students and teachers what advice they would give to juniors, and here is a summary of what they said. Get enough sleep before the day of the test. Read everything carefully and take an extra 30 seconds to read the directions and instructions so you are not confused. Pay attention to the prep happening in your classroom. Answer the questions you know first, eliminate the ones that are wrong, and don't leave anything blank. That's all we have for our ACT tips and tricks.
The reading challenge is going strong and has 2 weeks left. Make sure to turn in your pages every Friday for a prize.
Here are some sports for the week.
feel nice, like sugar and spice.
If you got skin like mine, you're under attack. The hate against my people gets deadly, but it's always been like this when we look back. It is a lot of weight that we carry. Before our ancestors, we do just that. And for my brothers and sisters, we must stay ready. Covered in gold, and our element is to be black.
Now, our reporter Mike has some things to do before the heat hits Arizona.
Hey, Pride. We all know that summer in the valley gets a bit... Yeah, that. But with the last few weeks of cool weather ticking down, it seems near impossible to see the awe-inspiring natural landscapes in time. So, in the interest of encouraging people to go out into the great outdoors, here are my three picks for the best outdoor sights you need to see before summer. First up is the new Predator Passage Trail at the Phoenix Zoo. With lions, hyenas, leopards, vultures, hogs, and a mob of meerkats on the way, this trail has plenty to offer even for Phoenix Zoo regulars. This trail also features an elevated walkway that offers great views of Hole in the Rock and Hunt's Tomb. Pricing is as follows, be sure to bring a camera. Next up we have South Mountain. There are more than 50 miles of trails on the mountain with varying degrees of difficulty. On any one of those trails you will see incredible views, fascinating flora, and maybe even some native Sonoran desert animals. And if you want a more curated experience, you can check out SMEEC, or the South Mountain Environmental Education Center, where you will find a museum-like assortment of information about everything the mountain has to offer. SMEEC is open Wednesday through Saturday from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. And lastly, the Boyce Thompson Arboretum, currently celebrating its centennial anniversary. If you can go to any one of these places, make it this one. I have seen some incredible sights all across Arizona, and the Boyce Thompson Arboretum is hands down at the top of my list. It has some of the most interesting trails and information out of anywhere I have visited.
We're here looking at beans.
The Arboretum has a wide variety of trails, from the easygoing Australian Desert Trail to the sometimes perilous high trail with its brilliant mountain views. Pricing is as follows, happy trails. That's all for announcements today, Pride.
Have a great rest of your day and
roll Pride.
Just move on up. For peace, you can